Go ahead.
What's been for Ashley, her level of scoring is extremely high. What's been working for her?
No, I think the biggest thing is, last year she was kind of staying still, shoot, and get an occasional rebound. And I think the biggest thing now is she's really figured out that, it's the old score three level kind of thing. Mm-hmm. And I think getting to the free throw line obviously has been huge. And, I think on half of her offensive rebounds, she's been fouled. So I think she has made I always tell them, the basketball gods reward effort. And when you play that hard and we get into the bonus and she gets to the free throw line, I think that's a huge part of, where she's getting her points.
What was practice like on Monday after the game on Sunday?
Good. We had a good day yesterday and did a lot of our stuff. Tried to get a lot of people involved, and then we'll put the we try and do our game planning on a 2-day cycle. That's kind of what you get into in the Big 12. So game plan for Alabama going today. But no, I thought we had a really good day. Very impressed. Very energy was good. The effort was good. And we got a lot of people in there. So I think it's a credit to them that they came back and did some things that we needed to do for our team. And now it's time to get ready to go play a game on Thursday.
For Ashley to go back into that big scoring role, and obviously she played for a long time as a pro. In your experience, do kids get back into that pretty easily? Because that's a role I would imagine a lot of people like. Or does it take a while to recalibrate?
Yeah,
she's ahead of the curve.
Yeah, they all love that. Yeah. No, I think she's a little ahead of it because I think the way she's scoring, and again, her free throw percentage is up and her rebounding numbers are up, but I think she knows she can score. She wants to score. Like you said, every kid wants to be the one that goes to the press conference and be the one that gets the shot. So her shot volume's not ridiculously high, which is a good thing. And I do think, like other kids that we've had, and I would put a Megan Taylor, a Bridget Carlton kind of in that same, their scores, I don't think they're going to be the knockdown shooters, but I mean, her percentage is in the upper 40s and her 3-point, all her numbers are good. Her free throw percentage is really good, and that's been the difference.
It's going to be the challenge for her with back-to-back high major games, where maybe the scouting reports will be a little bit more detailed.
A little bit different, a little more size, a little more physicality. Certainly playing on the road, you're not going to get a call or two. So she's got to be smart about it, and we got to be smart and put her in matchup situations. And the things that she got that where she's just driving to the basket probably isn't going to be there as often. So maybe, settle, be smart about a mid-range shot. I think we got to give her some more threes. She's been driving to the basket a lot. But the other stuff, the rebounding and, the things that are facilitating some of that scoring, hopefully stays there. Because obviously as you move up in class, so to speak, from a competitive standpoint, and that's what we're going to have, that those numbers are going to change, but it's still important that she does the things that allow her to get there in the first place.
How's Kristin?
Good. Yeah, she's good. She practiced yesterday. I think she was more scared than anything. That was a big kid that fell on her. I think we all would have been a little scared. So, she said she felt good. It was more, like I said, I think the instant reaction was, oh no, not again. But it wasn't the same thing. It was just fell in an awkward spot. She wasn't all stretched out and all that stuff. But she practiced probably more yesterday than she's practiced in a long time. And she wanted to get the extra work because she only played, I think, 13, 15 minutes on Sunday. So she was good.
How big is this Alabama game as an opportunity?
Oh, it's a great opportunity. I think these are fun. You're not only representing your own program, but you're representing the Big 12. These challenge series have become really popular in college basketball, and I think they're a great thing. And you know when you go on the road and you play this kind of game, it's what you're going to see in the Big 12. You're going to see high major athletes in a tough environment, and you learn a lot about your team when you go on the road in these kind of games. So it's a great opportunity to play and play a school that a university that's so well known for having high level academics and athletics, and so we're looking forward to hopefully go down there and play. I've never been to Alabama University. I've been to the state, but I've never been to the University of Alabama. So look for the Steve Prohm statue somewhere on campus, and sure have a nice conversation with Coach Saban. Sure he remembers me from Toledo when he was our coach. So no, it should be fun. I think the kids are excited about it, and I think we're excited about the opportunity that's ahead of us.
What challenge does that Alabama team present?
I think the biggest challenge with Alabama is their size and their length. I mean, we haven't seen that except with our scout team guys. They're going to run 11 people at us and, you know, four kids, you know, 6'3 or bigger and a lot of length, a lot, you know, typical SEC athletic competitive kids. Christy Curry, their coach, we know really well, has always done a great job. She did a great job at Tech and now she's doing some good things at Alabama too. So it's just going to be a whole different world than what we've been used to. And but that's what non-conference basketball turns into. It'll be more better rebound the ball, better, you know, everything that they do is going to be at a higher pace with bigger bodies, especially rebounding wise. When you go on the road, foul trouble, defensive rebounding, those kind of things are always things that are in the back of your mind. And it'll be a good test for us to see where we are playing that kind of team.
Nicole told us Maddie wasn't going to play, but she didn't make the trip.
Yeah, she'll make the trip. They